Right, for those playing along at home, how much metal have we lost? About 50 grams lost to scale. Now, we've run into a little bit of a snag. This is my existing eye drift, and this is the eye that it's going to go into. It's too small. There's way too much eye there for this. So I'm going to have to pause this for a moment whilst we make a tool. Now what we're going to do is make a new eye drift. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to take this piece of, don't know what it is actually, pointed chisel, single point chisel I guess, which is, let's see, inch and an eighth flat to flat, or inch and a quarter across the points of the hexagon. And we're going to upset a little bit on the end, draw out a new hammer eye drift. This one will be a little more multi-purpose, up to quite a bit bigger. And try and keep the thickness upwards of a probably about 19 to 20 millimeters if we can. And we'll see how we go. So today's video we won't be progressing this all that much. If anything, we'll be making a tool to help with that. And as an aside, for those wondering what my source of the wrought iron was, it's one of these suspension components. So I've basically reforged this section here. I used a piece like this for a hammer project a couple of weeks back. So I've been lucky to get into a good stash of quite high quality wrought iron, quite well refined wrought iron recently, so very lucky. So let's get things hot and we'll start working on a new hammer eye drift out of this piece of mystery steel, which is probably some sort of medium carbon general purpose steel. Upsetting, you've got to keep it straight. going to stop filming for a little bit, get as much done as I can, and then we're going to neck down towards the tip, because the tip is going to be inside the bar at this point. Alright, so, an hour and a bit later, just about done. Wider than it should at the tip, so I'm going to take it back just a little bit.
leave in the furnace, forge one to cool off. So I'll do the best I can and get it all around.
Alright, so where does that leave us? So that leaves us with a fair bit of grinding to do this afternoon at some point, and an axe to finish during the week. I will endeavour to get some video of the hardening and tempering of the drift. If I don't, then I will definitely show the drift prior to using it on the actual axe head at a later point. So yeah, that's where we're at.